light that you've given me died, and don't desert my mind, but let the one who serves you praise you again and again.
God. Thank you. Good morning. Generous of some of you to play along. I am, in fact, aware that it's 8 o'clock in the evening. I'm talking about a different morning, the one that King David tells us about in Psalm 30. Allow me to read you a few verses from King David's great message from the morning. I will exalt you, Lord, for you lifted me up, and you did not let my enemies rejoice over me. Lord God, I cried out to you, and you healed me. Lord, you brought my soul up from the realm of the dead. You kept me alive that I should not go down to the pit. Sing praise to the Lord, you his saints, and praise when you remember his holy name. For his anger lasts but a moment, but his favor lasts a lifetime. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. So far the word. Please remember for a moment a night that you have spent sleepless, tossing and turning, thoughts boiling in your head, perhaps greater grief than you had ever known. Or maybe you were so sick that you could hardly comfortably close your eyes, let alone catch a moment's rest. How we long for the first streaks of sunlight on a night like that to tell us that it's finally over, that the day has finally come. Well, do I need to convince you that this world is darker than the worst of these nights? Hatred and lies and persecutions and injustice and dishonesty. Examples come to your minds, let me add a few more. Persecutions of our brothers and sisters in Nigeria, Iran, North Korea, elsewhere. Crimes against the most vulnerable all around the world and even in our own country. Oh, but you don't have to look around the world, do you? Or even around your pew. Look within your own heart to find an affinity for hiding in the darkness so that if it were possible, God himself would not know that our actions have not been actions of the day, but of the night. What shall God do with people who don't even want the night to be over? Who do not look for the morning to come? For such people, the Bible speaks about the last day as a day of darkness and shadows and gloom and despair. For those who do not want the night to be over, for those who love the night, there is no morning coming. Rather, the darkest night of all. Such were some of you. Enter our Lord Jesus. Here is one who has lived from eternity in heaven's light with his Father. After that night that you remember, what would it have cost when the morning finally came for you to go back into the night? Is there any price you would have taken? Yet isn't this what our Lord has done for us? He came from heaven's light into a world of darkness, and he let the darkness cover him so that God's wrath could be poured out on him and there wouldn't be any left for you. He saved you from the hell that was opening wide to swallow you by entering it himself. He taught you to long for something better than the night, and then he gave it to you. What then? King David's advice, sing praise to the Lord, you his saints. Praise when you remember his holy name. Yes, rejoice in the Lord who brought you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Raise your voices and sing with us this evening. Go home and sing the morning to each other and to those who are still trapped in that miserable darkness that you once called home. Consider how you may support those who train for this purpose at our ministerial schools. Encourage the young and old among you to consider training for this purpose themselves. Pray for those of us who are being so trained. David says, I will exalt you, Lord, for you have lifted me up. See, we Christians, we have it good. We have been, first of all, completely lifted out of this pit of sin and death. We, second of all, have an almighty, all-knowing, all-loving God who promises to hear us when we call to him and to lift us out of all of our troubles. But if the darkness of this world weighs on your heart, if perhaps it does keep you up at night, consider this. Your salvation is as certain as the sunrise. Notice, please, that we do not read, "Weeping endures for a night, and joy may come in the morning." Joy comes in the morning. The Lord says through the prophet Jeremiah, "If you can break my covenant with the day and my covenant with the night, so that there will not be day and night, then my covenant may also be broken with my servant David." In other words, if you can stop the sun from rising, then perhaps God's love and forgiveness can be stopped from dawning on you and raising you up from this dark world to eternal glory and light in heaven. But you can't. And they can't. And you are saved. I'd like to leave you this evening with the words of the Scottish pastor George Matheson, who was blind from the age of 20 but saw a brighter light dawning with the eyes of faith. And he wrote these words, "O joy that seekest me through pain, I cannot close my heart to thee. I trace the rainbow through the rain and feel the promise is not vain, that morn shall tearless be." Amen. Please rise.
Oh,
Do you feel the world is broken?
We do.
Do you feel the shadows deepen?
We do.
But do you know that all the dark won't stop the light from getting through?
We do.
Do you wish that you could see it all made new? Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and open the scroll?
The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave, he is David's root and the Lamb who died to ransom the slave. Of all blessing and honor and glory.
Is he worthy of this?
He is.
Oh.
You may be seated. Thank you so much for joining us here at St. Paul's. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Jeff Rue, and I serve as the pastor here at St. Paul's. Thank you for joining us tonight on this blessed occasion. Wow. I mean, what else can you say? Just absolutely incredible, beautiful work. Professor Adrian Smith, thank you so much. College Choir, thank you so much for sharing with us the gospel in beautiful song. Thank you so, so much. Take a look. These guys and gals, Lord willing, will be your future pastors and teachers one day. So please pray for them. Pray that God would bless their studies as they continue to prepare for the gospel ministry. Because one day they may be serving you, you may be serving alongside them one day. So please pray for these young men and women. Pray for the ministry of Martin Luther College, and for that matter, all of our seminary educational schools, or ministerial educational schools, I should say. I guess just one quick announcement. Well, this is our 150th anniversary here at St. Paul's. So this was a wonderful, wonderful sacred concert. This was one of the things that we really wanted to have as part of our anniversary celebration. So thank you so much for coming here. And we certainly pray that God would give you safe travels on the way back to New Ulm tomorrow. Of course, you got one more left. One more left. So please pray that God would grant them safe travels. Those of you who are hosting these wonderful guys and gals behind me, why don't you remain in the sanctuary? I know they're going to disrobe and get all their stuff together, and then we'll try to get them off to their host families. And just a reminder that we do spring ahead 1 hour. I know. Especially for those guys. You know, they're tired. Having been here before, I know you guys are tired, and then they lose an hour of sleep. So just a reminder of that as you prepare to worship tomorrow, but also especially host families, make sure you get the choir members here at 7:15 tomorrow morning with the time change. So with that being said, God's richest blessings to all of you. And again, let's thank the Martin Luther College Choir for coming here tonight.